I don't want to mention his name on it. My close friend in the afternoon there. Really,
that was funny.
He comes in here yesterday, Hank, and just back from Louisville. I guess maybe he's still under a lot of stress that he didn't pick the winner any more than the rest of us did. And he's telling me before his show about the fact, oh, you know, they really got an exciting young team to watch, the Marlins. And I said, you don't understand. Nobody cares. You don't get it, Hank. There is no interest. There is none. And I explained to him that on Sunday, on a beautiful, perfectly sunny day, with no threat of rain, with no great humidity or high temperature, you know, low 80s, they had 10,000 announced and an actual crowd of 5,000, 6,000, 7,000 people there, maybe. So I'm driving home and Hank is going on about, well, you know, really, what a shame it would be to lose the day. See, a lot of you folks, you just in denial. You don't understand. I mean, you may have the best reindeer meat in the U.S., but, you know, take it to Finland and sell it. There's no interest in it here. No, seriously. You may have the best halava, but taking it to the North Pole, they don't like it up there. You know, you have to take it somewhere where they're interested in it. There is no interest here. So Bush and Carollo now, and the best part of the new deal is, yeah, the rumor is the deal is they're going to make us an offer so good we won't be able to turn it down. We heard that before?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Carollo says he hopes to craft a ballot measure. I love the way, do you hear the way that's, he's going to craft a ballot measure. In other words, if you're against the stadium, vote maybe. If you're for it, vote, we don't know, and yeah, and we'll figure out what you really mean. He hopes to craft a ballot measure that would go before the voters in July. And Bush said he'll ask Senate President John McCain and House Speaker Tom Feeney to make the plan a priority when legislature meets again in January. January, this is the middle of May. There are even whispers about maybe like a special session, which the governor says is highly unlikely, but don't ever count it out. Carollo says the voters would, in essence, be asked all the questions that are pertinent to a new stadium. It'll be something that will give the Marlins the assurance they need to move forward, whatever that means. In July. Am I going to be here in July?
No.
So don't blame me. I won't be here to lead the bandwagon. I'm sure George will do his part, since he hates sports anyway. But what a joke. And I think it's great. Put it on the ballot. Have a special election. I mean, evidently, the city of Miami, that's always on the verge of bankruptcy, they have unlimited funds. All of a sudden, unlimited funds to go and buy the land and do all of these other things. No problem. They're finding money all over the place. City and the county. Same county that can't give textbooks to your school to kids in school to take home. Oh, don't get me started on that again, because then Dave Hyde will start picking on me and saying, oh, there you go again with education, Neil. It's not gonna, getting rid of the Marlins won't save the schools. Right. Well, what a brilliant observation that is. But I'm sure we could probably find something better to spend that $120 million that they wanted from legislature on, not to mention all the other millions and millions and millions of dollars you're going to be subsidizing all these white elephants with for the next many, many years. Will they ever learn here?
No.
No. See, because these are people who, they're like our sales department, the Marlins. And the politicians who are in bed with them. They don't know one word.
No.
They don't know that word. Just like the old Julio Queens. They don't know that word.
No.
They don't know what it means. They just won't stop.
No.
Now, what is that?
No.
Kay?
No.
Just this one time, Kay?
No.
They don't get it. So it doesn't make any difference what the public say. They're going to continue hatching and plotting and planning. And I'm really worried in July if that goes on a ballot, because Hank yesterday indicated, what I heard from him tells me again that he's wavering, he's waffling. He's waffling. Now, nobody loves hockey more than I do, but you know something? If Wayne came on TV at noon today and said, well, we have found a legal loophole and we're able to break the lease with the Mac Arena because we can't find a new buyer for the hockey team and we're going to move them to Tennessee. Where the hell were you just in town? Give me Knoxville. They already got Nashville. We're going to move them to Knoxville, Tennessee.
Johnson City.
Johnson City. Batavia, New York. We're going to move the Panthers. Would I shed any tears?
No.
No. I just don't care anymore. I don't care to the point where I stopped going. And I, just like with the Marlins, I get my tickets for free. I don't care. I stopped going because, not because they were losing, but because it wasn't entertaining, because it was depressing, because there was nobody there, and for good reason there was nobody there. It was a waste of time. It's a social club. And when you dilute something, and like I talked about the other day, if Ruth Chris started serving hamburger, I think they would lose most of their clientele very fast. And then if they started serving like really low-grade hamburger, I don't think anybody would be going there. And it's the same thing. Oh, yeah, but come back. Our hamburger is better this week. Well, too late. You've already blown it. Too bad. We found other things to do, other things to eat. And it's the same thing with these sports moguls, you know, with all these multi-billionaires. You keep watering it down. You know, we spent out taxpayer dollars. They finagle. They come up with some cockamamie scheme. We build these big, gigantic, beautiful palaces. And then if things don't quite go quite your way, you just, you know, you savage, you trash the organization. You leave us with a shadow of what we had before. And anybody doesn't believe that, if you watch the Buffalo-Pittsburgh series, Game 5, Stu Barnes scores the winning goal for Buffalo in overtime. Game 6 last night, Marty Straka scores the winning goal in overtime for the Penguins. And who are the names we keep hearing during the game last night? Straka and Barnes, and there's Rhett Warner again, and there's Jason Woolley. Scott Mellenby doing great there in St. Louis. They win 4 in a row from Dallas. All those guys are still playing. So if the Panthers disappeared tomorrow, I mean, you know, I'd miss going to some of the games, like the 2-year when Toronto plays here. But other than that, I don't care, really. I don't care anymore. So don't give me this big song to dance about, well, gee, I really like baseball. If they paid me by the pitch, and there was no bigger baseball fan in the world than me when I was growing up as a kid, and that lasted for many, many, many years, for most of my adult life. And when they had their last work stoppage, and when they basically slapped the public in the face and said, oh, we're not even having a playoff World Series this year, whatever year that was, 94, whenever it was. At that point, I said, screw you guys. And then, of course, when the salaries just kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and everybody said, oh, well, gee, we can't make any money, and the owners start crying. Well, what are you crying about if you're paying guys $252 million? How do you expect to make any money? We're not going to subsidize it. So I just don't have any interest. It's just big business. And all these people who are waxing poetic about, oh, well, there's nothing better than taking your kids to a ball game and having a hot dog. Well, that's all ancient history now. That's all in the past. It doesn't exist anymore. It's a figment of your imagination. You're living in the distant past. Now it's just brazen, big business where guys just whore themselves out to the highest bidder. You got a bunch of mercenaries out there. And whoever pay them the greatest amount of money, that's where they'll go. They don't give a flying crap about any of you. There's no loyalty. There's no allegiance. There's no continuity. Who the hell's on the team? Who are these guys? Oh, yeah, but they got a bunch of good young guys. But who the hell are they? Nobody cares. So you can give a song and a dance on there, Hank, about how you know, it would be embarrassing to lose baseball. And let's come on. What difference does it make how many stadiums you build? The problem isn't the stadium in the first place. Everybody knows that. There's nothing wrong with that stadium. It's in a perfect location. You're driving right off the turnpike. The problem is that the owner got sucked into a bad deal.